A team of elite U.S. soldiers called the Green Berets were deployed in secret last year to the Saudi Arabia-Yemen border to help defeat the Houthi rebels. Since the Yemen conflict began 3 years ago, Houthi rebels have launched ballistic missiles towards Riyadh and other Saudi Arabian cities on numerous occasions, and the kingdom has responded with its own airstrikes. 12 Green Berets were deployed to the border in December 2017, just weeks after Saudi Prince Mohammed bin Salman renewed his call for American support, claimed the kingdom had intercepted the latest missile shot at the Riyadh airport. Officials from President Donald Trump's administration, as well as European and Arab diplomats, told the New York Times the troops are helping locate and destroy training sites and missiles of the Houthis. Part of their mission is to also train Saudi troops on how best to defend their border with Yemen. The newspaper reported that the rebels pose no direct threat to the U.S. The Pentagon had previously said its role in the conflict was limited to refueling, logistics, and general intelligence sharing. The war in the region's poorest country began in 2014 when Houthi rebels took control of Sana'a and pushed south towards Aden. Saudi Arabia and its coalition, fearing that the rebels were being backed by its rival Iran, then launched a series of airstrikes to restore control for the government of President Abd Rabbu Mansur Hadi. The Houthis, who hail from northern Yemen, control Sana'a and much of the country's north, which borders Saudi Arabia and the key Hodeida port on the Red Sea coast. Since the airstrikes began, at least 10,000 people have died as a result and 40,000 have been wounded. The conflict has also played a large part in causing a cholera epidemic and leaving millions facing famine and severe malnutrition. UK government says its heart goes out to relatives of Yemen wedding airstrike victims but refuses to halt arms sales to Saudi. There is no indication that the American commandos have crossed into Yemen as part of the secretive mission, the newspaper reported, and the Pentagon have cited security reasons for not commenting on the matter. Safe to say that the operation includes limited non-combat support, such as intelligence sharing, according to Major Adrian Rankin Galloway. Democratic Senator Tim Kaine, a member of the Armed Services Committee, called the Green Berets mission purposeful blurring of lines between train and equip missions and combat. He has renewed his call for Congress to pass a new authorization of use of military force, AUMF, since the U.S. Congress is the only body that has the ability to declare war. The U.S. has been operating in several conflict zones around the world under the same AUMF since 2001, which were war powers passed just days after the September 11 attacks when the U.S. military began its ongoing war in Afghanistan. There are also U.S. intelligence experts in the southern Saudi city of Najran that have been working with Saudi troops. Despite Mr. Trump's ever closer ties to Saudi Arabia, he had asked the kingdom to end a blockade on Yemeni ports last December, possibly around the time the Green Berets had been deployed. Mr. Trump had said in a statement that he had directed U.S. officials to call Saudi Arabian leaders and request they completely allow food, fuel, water and medicine to reach the Yemeni people. He said at time that Yemenis desperately need it. More about Yemen. Saudi Arabia Green Berets U.S. military reuse content.